You know, they don't come and say, "Oh, we want." I know of an Hollywood producer who told me he purposely keeps his movies watery because if he takes it a notch higher, he's going to lose the audience he has. But what I say to you is, who has the driving? Who's at the driver's seat? The driver's seat is still me and you who get a chance to determine what goes out there. I'll give you a perfect example. Music got to a point where it became almost irritating. You put a Nigerian CD on of mixes. Yeah, when I say mix, you know what I mean. Different artists who are popular and their songs, one song each. And you feel like you just heard one song for 1 hour because it sounds the same. It's so bad that the lyrics begin to even sound the same. The choice of words, Baba God, you know, all of that.
Bentley.
The Bentleys, the Woman's Anatomy. It's the
Gucci
same.
Ferrari, it's always okay, the good. Same things.
Now, all of a sudden, it started, let's be honest, it started with Burna Boy a little. Yeah? Burna slowed down his sound. I was amazed with the sound, the way Like the Party sounded. But even much later, he went a little lower, and he sounded like, you know, I hear it's called Al-Qaeda or something, right?
Yeah, okay. It was just very slow and mellow. And
oh, exactly. Now, after Burna had done that, you would notice that the man they call, what's his name now, the Ghanaian, Nigerian
drag... Mr. Easy.
Mr. Easy.
He's Nigerian.
Okay. The guy caught up in the jollof rice situation. Mr. Easy came in, did one song. So let's not take it away from Burna Boy, because he was pretty good at that. But Mr. Easy came in, he did one song, did a second one, did a third one, and he kept sounding like that. We kept slowing it down, you know, we started slowing down, enjoying
it. Now everybody's slow.
My brother, then what's his name, what's the guy?
Runtown
now came. And boom, we said, okay, you know what, maybe we should slow down. And then Davido.
I don't know why I'm laughing.
No, think about it, I'm just a practical example.
Yes.
And then Davido. Probably one of the most monstrous songs since Nicis Conguaso.
Yeah.
Right? Now, what has happened? Everybody, including P Square, have all run to the studio and they're all slowed down. Everybody who's buying anything now.
So there's no identity anymore.
It's not. Sorry?
There's no identity for any.
No, I just showed artist. You practically
yeah.
how the music makers can change what the viewers want.
Okay.
And this simple thing with this song, of this music sound I've given to you now, put it in the movies, put it in TV shows, put it in whatever you do, serve quality to the people constantly, they would accept it and make that their preference. So because you successfully tried to serve some fluke with some very watery piece of, you know, entertainment, and it got hung on, doesn't mean we should stay there or die there.
What about lyrics? Because that one in particular, I hear it's the fans, that the fans don't want anything they can't sing along to.
Mm.
So you have a lot of these songs with amazing beats.
Can't you sing along to the Mali songs?
There's just three lines in the entire song. I want you to think about that. We're going to come back and I'll get your opinion on that.
Okay.
I hope you're enjoying this conversation. So please stay with us. Welcome back. If you're just joining us, where have you been? It's been an amazing conversation here with Emmanuel Ugoli, a broadcaster. And before the break, we're talking quickly about, you know, lyrical content in Nigeria and how we can work on that very quickly.
Lyrically, I think that we need to wake up. It's a pity that we think it's okay once the songs that we have are watery. The biggest stars in the world who are all dead are still living in our heads because of the things that they said. Doesn't matter if it's hip hop and Tupac, or it's R&B and Manita Big, and you know, the best of the names that you have with the R&B or reggae music and Bob Marley. It's content. Notorious B.I.G. is content. Fela is content. All we remember about these guys after they go were the things that they said. So we quote them. Some of them make their ways into university colleges with the things that they say as emphasis for the students to learn from. So we have a golden opportunity here to be dropping lines of saying things, and we're throwing it away on Versace and Gucci. But I mean, I don't think it makes any kind of sense, you know.
He actually does. I mean, as much as
we enjoy
the songs for the wateriness of it, it really is a shame that, I mean. Well, let's leave that. I want to talk about you now personally. Now, no, you did have a few health challenge in the last couple of years. I know you had surgery at some point. You put up on your social media recently about your sister donating a kidney to you at the time.
Sure.
But we also saw you raising funds recently again because you have to have another surgery.
Yeah.
And people are wondering, if you're looking for money, why are you still agile and still laughing and your baritone is so strong? How are you doing?
I'm one of those who don't enjoy a pity party. I believe that no matter how hard it is for you in your life, you should be strong enough to keep pushing. Not everybody has the internal strength to keep trying to do everyday things when they're struck by unusual, not so everyday problems.
Yeah.
You understand? But, you know, there's some things I found out, e.g., people around you, your parents, your friends,
yeah,
your family, they're strengthened by your ability to stay strong.
Yeah.
You know, I've learned that and I've decided personally, regardless of how hard it is or what I have to deal with, I'm not going to sit down on a bed. The slightest opportunity my energy gives me to do something, yeah, I get it done.
So, but you're still on dialysis?
I do dialysis three times a week.
Three times a week?
Yeah, that's 15 hours every week. I don't have a choice. I lay on my back and have all the blood in my body brought out and you know, what's the word? Refined and returned,
back,
you know,
into
the
it,
stuff
yeah
that the kidney doesn't do anymore.
Yeah.
But every time I get a chance to talk about kidneys, yeah, I'll quickly say this one sentence that matter. Please, the things that cause kidney problems are not the usual things that people, you know, banter about. There are things like taking tablets, painkillers, you know, something I was very, 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 very guilty of. Taking painkillers. I was taking mine because of gout. I had gout and I was also hypertensive at the same time. So it wasn't a good combination. That's really what packed my kidneys off. So if you're the kind that pops Tramadol or Panadol without
constantly
a doctor's prescription, you have to stop that immediately. You also have to be the kind of person who understands that there's a lot of importance with taking a lot of water into your system. Dehydration can make you lose your kidneys. As easy as it sounds, it's very serious. Okay, then also, if you have hypertension and diabetes running in your family, please be
check
the kind.
Yourself.
It's very simple. Walk into it. You want to do a kidney function test. That's what it costs. It won't cost you 10,000 naira. And you don't want to get to where I've gotten. You don't want to get to. If you get here, you'll be doing 400K every month to stay alive, whether you like
wow
it or not.
Well, to find out more about Ima's situation, please follow him on Instagram. His Instagram is amazing. @Ima_Ogoli. It's just @Ima_Ogoli.
@Ima_Ogoli. Yeah.
@Ima_Ogoli. So,
yeah,
so you can find out how you want to be a part of, you know, helping out probably, which I think is very important. Quickly now before we go,
yeah,
The Gist, which is the show you do. Very quickly, please. In 30 seconds, where do we watch?
Yeah. Right now it's on Hip TV, channel 324. We've moved on to Rave TV, moved on to Wazoga Max. We're going doing AIT as well, coming down to channels, terrestrial TV, cable TV. We're spreading the word. The word here is quality. We talk about the industry and industry only, but what we talk about are the things that are wrong, the things that we see. Why do you come for a show at 7 o'clock? Why does it have to start at 1 a.m.? You know, and the likes of that.
Yeah.
So all the things about the industry of entertainment that are wrong that nobody's talking about, I'm not afraid to talk about.
So, as you can see.
So I bring it to the table, and that's what the Gist is about.
Yeah.
And we try to make sure it's corrective as much as it is entertaining.
All right.
Yeah, that's
thank you very much, Ima Ogoli. And if you, like I said, if you want to hear more of his baritone.
Yeah, and I have to say Buksu. I have to say Buksu.
At Ima Ogoli on Instagram, and then, of course, you can follow him. You can watch him on Hip TV every Saturday at 10 a.m. Thanks for being here today.
My pleasure.
Like I always say, you can follow the conversation at Twitter, @YNiger_TV is the handle. The hashtag to follow is Robbie Minds. You can also visit the website, YNiger.TV. Remember, you've never seen young people talk like this before. I'll see you next week.